This roll of ColorFabb XT-CF20 has been sitting untouched in my shelf for over a year now. Now, I finally found the time to put this carbon fiber filled material through its paces. This week, we'll be looking at print quality, mechanical strength, and temperature performance of this more exotic material, and I'll also talk about some safety concerns. Guten Tag, everybody, and welcome to CNC Kitchen. ColorFabb XT-CF20 comes nicely sealed on 750g spools that sell for 50 bucks, which gives it a price of $67 a kilogram. This filament is based on ColorFabb's XT material, which is co-polyester based and filled with 20% carbon fibers. The carbon is added as short fibers, which during the printing process orientate themselves in the print direction, which gives the part very unique properties on which I'll come later. When printing this kind of filled materials, it's very important to use abrasion resistant nozzles because otherwise the inside of your hot end will erode away in no time. I used a hardened steel 0.4mm nozzle from E3D, which is capable of handling this task. Tungsten or ruby nozzles are also an option, but never ever print reinforced filaments with brass or stainless steel nozzles. Usually I print my whole set of test samples and then analyze them. Unfortunately, I noticed after the first run that the printed parts showed quite a lot of porosity, probably due to moisture, so I dried the roll of filament in my oven at 65 degrees Celsius for around 6 hours and reprinted all of the material test samples, and this filament test ended up to be way more effort than I anticipated. The first thing I noticed was that instead of an extrusion factor of 100%, I now needed to increase it significantly to 113% to get good prints. I printed all of the parts as always on my original Prusa Mark IIs, where I added some Magic Goo on the 70 degree bed and didn't have any warping or first layer adhesion problems as soon as the first layer thickness was set correctly. I tried fan speeds between 0 and 100%. Where, starting at 25%, the overhanging parts of the prints look very nice. In the end, I settled with 35% fan for the rest of the samples. I tried nozzle temperatures between 230 and 270 degrees Celsius, which all of them worked fine, though 250 degrees looked the best and had proper layer adhesion, so this was the temperature I used for the rest of the samples. Since the material is a co-polyester, I had some issues with bits of material sticking to the nozzle and the heat block, which let loose from time to time and ended up on my parts. Overhangs printed great up to 65 degrees, and boy, look at these outer surfaces. The matte look gives these parts a finish I haven't seen so far with any other material. The material doesn't string, but left some nasty material blobs at the stringing test, though fine details came out well. Playing around with retraction settings and using dried material would probably increase the quality. Bridging was strange because at first the part looked really awful. Out of curiosity, I used Slicer Prusa Edition instead of Simplify 3D, which made such a difference. Almost perfect bridging, even at the largest gap. I tried to tune the settings in Simplify 3D, but nothing I did improved the print quality, which is really strange. The 3D Banshee reflects these results because it showed the blobs at the retraction points and some material bits at a couple of places. Still, if you overlook these, then the rest of the boat looks stunning with the matte black finish. Let's now take a look at the material properties of ColorFabb XT-CF20. The tensile strength of around 45 megapascals before drying it wasn't very impressive and even lower than regular, unfilled PETG. After drying the material, it improved more than 20% and ended up with 55 megapascals, which is better but still below regular PLA. Layer adhesion was only okay, and the specimens printed standing failed at 18 megapascals, which is only 1/3 of the strength of the lying specimens. The tensile modulus, so the stiffness of the material, is what really stands out, because with almost 3000 megapascals, it is the most rigid material I printed so far. This is the first time when I also tested the stiffness perpendicular to the printing direction, so the upright specimens. If we take a look at a microscope shot of the material, we see that the carbon fibers orientate themselves in the printing direction, and these fibers give the material its superb rigidity. Perpendicular to the printing direction, they are only barely adding strength and stiffness, which is verified by my second test that showed a tensile modulus of only 1100 MPa in this direction. So keep this in mind with your designs. If you use fiber reinforced materials, they have very different properties in and perpendicular to the printing direction. The filament test also confirmed the superior stiffness of this material, even in comparison to PLA. The slope at the beginning of the test indicates the modulus. The steeper it is, the more rigid a material is. My test hooks failed at around 50 kg of load, which is in the mid-range. The standing one only was able to bear 16 kg until failure, which confirms the previous tests. Temperature resistance was good and the material stayed rigid up to 80 degrees and then totally failed at 85 degrees Celsius. The impact strength was okay and an improvement over regular PETG or PLA, but far away from the toughness of, for example, polycarbonate. I've been mentioning safety concerns in the beginning. This material is filled with lots of very tiny fibers, which might come loose during printing, cleaning or reworking. I wasn't really feeling comfortable printing XT-CF20 in my office, and when reworking this material, which by the way works very well, a respirator is definitely a must. I don't know if I'm overcautious, but I have a bad feeling having these particles in my office. What do you guys think? All in all, it was very interesting for me to work with ColorFabb's XT-CF20. It requires some special setup due to the special nozzles needed, but delivers stunning looking parts. Overall, strength was only okay, but the stiffness of the material is really standing out. If you need a material that is stiffer than most other materials, this is definitely not a bad choice. If you require only strength and toughness, there are other materials around that might be more suitable. You can find links to the material and the test methods I used down in the description. The detailed test report, together with the printing profile and all of the test samples, are available for my Patreons. If you enjoyed this video and learned something, then hit the like button and subscribe to the channel for more. If you have suggestions and comments about my methods, please leave them down below and let me know what other materials you would like to see me investigate in the future. Until then, thanks for watching, auf Wiedersehen, and until next time.